Hello everyone and welcome back to Expansion Gaming. I'm your host Devin and today I am bringing you some World of Warplanes. Well, let's just go ahead and hop right in. We're going to start off with the AO-192 German aircraft. We're just going to go ahead and hop right on in. Remember everyone, leave a like and comment down below and of course, feel free to subscribe. So for those of you who have not played World of Warplanes before, it's just like most of the other World of War games. There are multiple types of planes. They do different tasks and have different specialities. And it's up to you, the pilot, to actually fly it to the best of your ability. Hopefully this game starts up here quick. Unlike the others, it doesn't really show you how many other planes are out there searching. All you can do is kind of just hop in and hope for the best. So essentially in this, there are two different ways to win. All the battles are pretty much the same. You have multiple ground forces that are all controlled by AI computers. There are little bases, forts, little anti-air things, little ships over the water. Basically, you can win by destroying all of those. And if you have a destroyer, which are these little triangles, that's what your goal is. You specialize in being able to destroy all these little red dots on the ground. And then you have these little triangles, which are the light aircrafts. You are zippy, you turn quickly, you maneuver very well, and you might not pack the best punch, but you're quite zippy. Then you have ones like mine, which are the heavy aircraft fighters. The definition of a fortress. We don't turn very well, we might not be the fastest, but you can take some good hits. And, as you can see, this little boost render is how long the headline engines actually could be. Now also, in this, you have mixed fighter planes, which are those weird little, like, teardrop shapes. Alright, looks like we're gonna hop right in. They specialize in either air combat or destroying the ground combat. That's not a good start. We're actually gonna hop right over here. Oh, that's not good. We're gonna try and split off. Target hit. We are not doing well at the start of this. It looks like an enemy plane just crashed right into the ocean. And we've overheated our engines, so we don't have our boost anymore. Let's see if, at the very least, we can get this plane to go blow up before we do. Nope. But that's the gist of this game. It's just your basic flight simulator. You fly around, you shoot, and you try not to die. I will go ahead and actually show you guys my destroyer, the TSH-2. I believe this is one of the Russian planes. So let's give this a whirl again, and hopefully this time it goes a bit better. So I'd like to get something started. I want to start a question of the day for you guys to answer down in the comments below. So I want to get your feedback on that, and that's actually going to be our first question of the day. Is just, what do you feel about actually answering these questions? I know it seems silly, but I would love to start interacting with all of you. And by all of you, I mean like the 20 so people that actually watch my videos. I'd love to start interacting with you guys and actually start getting some good constructive feedback. And it looks like this one's going to take a bit longer. I don't think there are as many people that actually play the World of Warplane series. Now, it says no suitable opponents and it wants us to select another aircraft. If you actually wait until about 2, 3 minutes, it should go in. If it hasn't gone by about 2.5, you know it's probably not going to, and we will actually select another one at that point, but waiting isn't bad. Gives me some time to actually just sit back and talk to you guys. And of course, as soon as I say that, boom, in a game. So, this time around, we are a destroyer craft. We do not have the best anti-air available. We actually are meant to destroy the ground forces. That is our main job. Take a look at the map here. We're going to start off and we're actually going to break away and try to hit this line in about that order. Or we might actually swoop around, hit this one, and then hit this line up here. So let's turn off. There's our first target down there. Now, the hardest thing about this game is once you get close to the ground, it becomes much harder to climb back up in altitude. So once you're down here, you're pretty much down here. Upside to that is that people that want to shoot you are going to have to dive down at you. That's also a downside because it's very easy to dive down and actually get many, many hits on you. But on the upside, that increases their chance of actually crashing. See what I mean? We just absolutely obliterate these targets. We don't want to turn around. And it looks like we have another destroyer heading right at us. And he ran right into us. I'm honestly not sure how we survived that and he didn't. But I'm not going to argue. So we're going to circle back around and try to finish this off. And there we go. Now, looks like our best target's going to be over here at this point. Like I said, it's not easy to start climbing back up in altitude. And looks like we already got some people hitting us. It's not hitting trees. And we're just going to go right over to these ships. And as you can see, destroying these does serve a purpose. It increases our overall score. And that is the other way to win. Now we're actually going to try... Oh, this is bad. I turned way too hard. See what I mean about we do not make good air fighters? We don't have the turn speed or the climbing ability. So we're just actually going to ignore him. Hopefully our teammates are able to get up behind us. But it doesn't look like it. It looks like we heavily are outnumbered. That's hilarious. My rear gunner actually shot him and caused him to crash. That does not happen often. These rear gunners, they don't really do much. They're there more to deter enemies from shooting you. So that's actually really, really rare for them to actually get a kill like that. It's also possible that we shot him, damaged his rudder, and made it next to impossible to pull up. And it looks like that is all she wrote. That will end this game, and it looks like overall we did just lose that game, so that's okay, it happens. It's all a learning experience. See, we got a good amount of money of experience just for actually doing the objective. So I'm actually going to open up the tech tree for this one. Sorry. This one. I want to open up the research upgrades, and I'll show you guys what this generally looks like. So we can open up, upgrade our plane body, our guns, our rear gun, our engines, and overall it will eventually lead to upgrading the aircraft. And it looks like with 510, I can actually go ahead and upgrade. We'll research, and then we will buy the purchase for this engine upgrade. And that's about all the experience we have for it. Looks like our German one got out, and it looks like our German tank, or not tank, sorry. I just got off of recording a World of War tanks video. Our destroyer battleship aircraft got out and actually won. Sorry, I didn't want to click service. I want to actually look at the upgrades. And it looks like we could upgrade, not upload. Upgrade our onboard weapons, rear gun, engine, and our guns. So if we upgrade our rear gun, it will eventually lead to the upgrade. And that's actually what we're going to go ahead and research and buy for this. As you can see, between ships, tanks, and planes is by far the most expensive for their in-game currency to actually buy and upgrade things. All right, so we are going to actually hop into the next game, and we are going to play as the P-26. It's one of those multi-fighters, so it does a pretty good job, but I want to hop in and actually show you guys what these tech trees look like. So as you can see, we went from the P-12 over here to the P-26 and all the way down. If we would have went over here for the little zippy planes, we would have gotten the P-23 and once again gone all the way down. And the same for this. We have in the US the two different types that we can get. We might actually go and re-get this one. Actually, we don't have to. We can just research and purchase this plane. Ta-da! And we have that aircraft. So the reason I actually wanted this is because down here it does eventually lead off. And just for you guys, we're gonna actually play the new one. So we're gonna hop in again. This plane looks kind of funny. It's got a little fat body, but that's because it is a, multi-fighter, multi-role fighter. Sorry, I've been calling it wrong this whole time. And for this multi-role fighter, we can do both, destroying the targets on the ground and actually having a decent fight. We will not be as quick or as strong as either one of the main roles, but we can actually do a good job in both functions. Once again, I just want to remind you guys, feel free to leave a like and comment down below and answer that question of the day, which is, how do you guys feel about starting questions of the day? I'll make sure that I actually respond to you guys down below, and of course, if you're not subscribed, feel free to. We're all here to have a good time and have some good old fun. All right, we are in a harbor battle, or sorry, a standard battle on the harbor map. It looks like we are the attacking force. And it looks like we should be able to hop in here very shortly. Type out the good old good luck, have fun. And it looks like somebody has a toaster. Let's go ahead and start up here. I love the little design of this plane. It has a comical kind of clown look. It has a fat little body and I love it. And honestly, this game just looks beautiful for a flight simulator, or sorry, a dogfight simulator. It has really good graphics, that is for sure. Beowulf style. See, compared to the other planes I've played so far, this one is much, much quicker in how it turns and rolls. Really don't want to be out too far this destroyer down here. Try and do a decent bank. Come around on this guy to actually get a shot off. So if you see that little circle I'm aiming for, because once again, like all their games, there is bullet delay of actually hitting. Oh. And that's how you lose an aircraft. I did exactly what the enemy in the last round did to us, and I plowed right into him. I don't think we destroyed him, but we definitely destroyed ourselves. I want to hop back into the AO-192 here, actually. I love the heavy fighter planes. I love being actually able to take some hits, and while we don't have the maneuverability of the light ones or the multi-role fighters, I love the concept and idea of being just a giant flying fortress. Kind of makes me think of, like, the boss raids or whatnot. The in-game boss monsters. Alright, looks like we got right into here. Looks like our AO-192 is actually just a tad bit better. I love little comparison charts that they do. Let's go ahead and hop in here. Don't really care too much for the little cinematic. But just look at this game. Look at how great it looks with all of its little fires, the actual ships firing on towns. This is just a really great looking game.
Good hunting.
Alright. So just like before, we're gonna start off by trying to climb higher and get us a better perspective. We don't want to overuse our engines too early, but let's see. It looks like we are dropping speed just a tad bit too much. Let's try to even out just a little bit so we're still gaining altitude and not losing as much speed. Right here. We'll start gaining speed and still just slowly gaining altitude.
Enemy contact!
And it looks like that's our first contact down there. Quite a few multiple fighters. Alright, let's break off. We're gonna go straight to this AR-68. And I'm sorry, I broke off before. That little circle that you see is actually where you want to aim. This game does do a great job of showing you that.
Target hit.
Because there is a delay in your shots.
You're under anti-aircraft fire.
I'm just gonna give you guys a quick demonstration. This is why I say that can't really destroy those as much. Plus, you're not made for pulling out afterwards. So we have 10 seconds of boost, and we're going to use this to our advantage and try to climb up. We don't want to overheat the engines, so it's taking longer. So we're going to cut it there. And we're going to try to slowly climb back up and rejoin this fight. We might get some shots on this P-26, but not too many. We don't have enough of an engine boost to get up much higher. Actually, better idea. We might be getting shot at, but this AO-192 is going to be our better target. Mono-E-Mono, same type versus same type. I don't believe he notices where we are at quite yet. Looks like we got a good few hits off. Let's see if we can follow behind him. Oh, someone almost crashed into us. Come on, come on, come on, come on. We're doing some heavy damage to him. We just about have him done. Ah, our guns have actually overheated, so we gotta give this a second. There we go. actually destroyed him now. We're actually going to loop around. We're going to help our teammates finish him off. We actually didn't need to, but it made me feel good about myself. Alright, so we're going to give our engines some time to cool off so we can boost back up. We're going to go over here to rejoin this fight. We're still a good bit of distance off. I don't think we have anybody behind us besides our teammates. Alright, we're going to be engaging on this AR-68 and helping out our teammate. Oh, he's flying right at us. That's an interesting strategy. Let's try and boost to speed this turn up. So while, of course, just holding down like I am is always an option, the better choice is to actually try to fire your guns at first. I just haven't mastered that yet. I find it easier just to continuous fire. Let's go on this demon plane. Alright, well, looks like we didn't really get an assist in helping that one, but we're gonna go over here and help our friendly heavy fighter. I don't know who that is from this distance, and this bulldog. We're approaching him at a decent speed, actually. Still not close enough to actually get a shot off. He's actually getting fired on by our ships. There we go. We're gonna try and... Nope. Never mind, I stand corrected. We're gonna try and dive bomb this guy. And we're gonna start to pull up now. I don't want to crash into the water at this point in the game. He's flying really close to that water, trying to get us to follow him. Fortunately, if we did, I don't see us lasting. Here we go. We got a couple shots off on him. Looks like our rear gunner actually did a good deal of damage to him. That's our last enemy we have left to fight. I don't know if we'll actually get there in time before our teammates take him out. Alright, everyone. Looks like this is actually going to be a GG here. There are three friendlies on this one enemy, and it looks like he's just going to dive straight into the ground. Trying to take out that last one for some points for his team. And looks like we're going to be the ones to finish him off. Yep. There we go. Congratulations, everybody. We actually got quite a good game in there. I want to thank you all very much for tuning in for this episode. For the last time, please leave a like and comment down below. Feel free, of course, to subscribe if you're not already. And enjoy your afternoon.